Hello and welcome to Wolfhound Gaming. My name is Michael. I hope you enjoy this episode of Ghost Recon Wildlands. I'm currently playing offline and we're gonna try this open beta. And we're gonna probably do a story mission. And we'll see how it goes. Hopefully we can do some stealth action going on. I've been playing it recently when it came out, and actually, to be honest, I find it quite hard. Not to say I have an excuse for that, but I was tired when I played every time. So let's hope for the best today. And may I say, the game looks really good. Landscape here looks magnificent, and like you can fly there with a helicopter. If you see all the way, see that road there, you can drive up there. You can also fly on top of these mountains there. So yeah, quite awesome. Okay. I'll probably upload some other time with a video where I'm playing online.
Hang on, I'll drive.
But for now, we're sticking with AI. So, I want to take on this story mission here. Let's see, actually I want to get some skills. Let's see, can I have, yeah, I can have thermal vision. I want thermal vision. Let's see, stealth. Maybe not unstable aim. Okay. Night vision, thermal, awesome. It looked like they jumped out on the road there. Let's avoid traffic by jumping out on the road. My magnificent driving skills. So you see the red spots on the map is obviously enemies. I haven't marked them yet. Okay, let's try out to go off the beaten track and let's try to have some fun. I think there's only a couple of enemies here. Oh shit! Wrong button!
Damn, they did not like the sound of that.
I think I'll hide behind here. How about that? Starting with the wrong button. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Okay, he's mine.
Got it, moving.
Okay, and then
let me get a good
and
sight
him.
Target acquired. Stay by. Hold up, let me get a good sight line.
On air.
Ready to engage. I'm opening fire on these shitheads.
Oh, that was close. This is going great. I have it on normal difficulty. I would say, yeah, it's kind of hard. You have to think through what you're doing. Like, reckless actions will get you in reckless situations, like I just did now. One more, and you have to really think about your actions. That's the truth about it. So
that's it, we're clear.
I'm gonna take this truck and continue on. Okay. I just want to show you. So I have the TAR-21, the silencer, and the Coyote red dot on it. I think it is. I'm using the M40A5 sniper rifle. Not necessarily the best sniper rifle, but it has the, quite a high rate of fire, and it's very silent. So, even though I have a silencer on these two snipers, you see that the noise is a lot higher, but they have like more range, more damage, and more penetration. But I quite like the M40. These are the two handguns you start out with. I'm just currently using this one, it's quite decent, so I like using that. Okay, moving on. I mean, the music sometimes. Okay, my OCD is tingling. Okay. Like I was talking about playing solo, to be quite honest, it's really difficult because, oh fucking shit, I can't go there. never mind. Yeah, to be frank, playing solo, it's really hard to work with the AIs because you have to basically tell them every move, and even though that's a great thing, like realistically when you're getting fired upon, it's not realistic that your teammates will just sit behind cover and do nothing. I feel like the AI should have more free will. I'm not saying complaining my playing on the AI. I know my playing is shit, but I don't necessarily want the AI to do all the job, but you know, I want it to act a bit more human. This mission is going to be hell if I can't maintain stealth.
Eyes on two right by the container.
Is to kill everyone in the base camp and then go on with the mission.
I got eyes on an air defense, but there's another one. That's 10.
Wow. Who was that? I wonder who that was.
Enemy marked.
Yeah. Okay. All right, I want to take these two guys. Need to relocate. I just want to turn this off in case I need to escape by helicopter. Let's see, okay. I guess we do this.
Inside and hack their message logs for intel. Let's move.
Let's see if I can do it with the rifle. No.
Got one.
Okay. There we go. Okay, so how do they get through there? Okay, maybe not.
I got the C4 primed.
There's a Sicario over here in the fire.
Wait, let me place a mine. There's a flash crash for these hombres.
Let's see if that hope works. I mean, let's hope that works.
Drone is airborne.
Okay.
That's 10 targets.
Okay. Should be someone here. No? Maybe in here? Yep. Knew it. That's one. That's 11 targets. Okay, so
hey, got a narco near the entrance to the building.
I'm in the simulator.
Oh, I always press the wrong button for that. Okay, so far so good. There's one more. Sorry for lack of speaking, I'm really concentrating. Just can't see him.
Lost my target. Roger, target acquired.
They are really struggling to get those. That was a close call. What? This is not turning out good. That looked like it hurts. Oh no. Is that a helicopter? One more here. Yeah, fuck off.
That's a kill. Clear over here.
That is far from a stealth. Complete a mission. Anyways, we managed to do it anyways. Blow this fucking gate open.
Frag out. My mierda culeros.
Really? Why do I fucking press that one? Yeah, the controls are a bit weird. Or maybe I'm weird. I think that's the thing. For some reason, when I want to change weapons, I press directional button up. Wonder if I can change that. Thing about the controllers, I'll probably change the drone. I'll probably have the drone on triangle and then weapon change on directional button up. Don't know why, but I think for me it feels like it takes longer to press triangle than it takes to press the directional button upwards. And also for like double, you have to actually double tap the triangle button to get your handgun out. If that was the directional button, I feel it would be a lot faster. Okay, let's see what this is. Okay. Heavy artillery. Let's go here. Okay, so we have basically done everything here. This is the size we're talking about. In the full release game, it will be this big. So it's massive. It's not like Just Cause 3, but Just Cause is Just Cause, so.
Should have a PSYOP unit down here, don't you think? Or MISO, or whatever they're called now. Shit, there might be one here already for all we know. Bowman plays her cards close to the chest.
You don't think Bowman's got other operators on here?
You think the activity's just a bunch of chairborne rangers? They might not be throwing lead, but somebody else is out here.
Okay, thank you so much for watching this episode of Wolfhound Gaming. And we'll continue doing some missions in the next episode. So thank you so much for watching. Cheers, over and out.
That was a civilian, genius.